sleepy. He's pretty sleepy. So I'm gonna go put him to bed. Okay, so today I'm going to be cutting my hair. I'm very excited. It's raining a little bit. You might be able to hear the sound of the rain. It's just drizzling right now. It just started. So I've basically just been wearing my hair up or curling it, and that's the only time I like my hair, so it's really time for a cut. So I have a clip here, and I have a clip in the back. And I haven't gotten a haircut in split ends were, and just like thinned out the ends. You'll see. So like at the time, I thought it was awesome because I was like, cool. This way I don't have to cut off any length because I was trying to grow it out. But it's made the ends extra jagged, and I mean, also my hair like just growing out like at an uneven pace. Because I haven't gotten a haircut in so long. You know, my hair just grows at different times. Also, I haven't gotten my hair bleached in a while. I've just been dyeing it purple with Arctic Fox. And yeah, I like this color. I want it to be darker because I think it looks better with my root growth when it's a darker purple. Alright. I really just wanted to give my hair a break from the bleach for a little bit. Around 14, I feel like it got very dark. I was blonde, and then it was like dirty blonde when I was a kid. It used to be really nice. I miss when it was dirty blonde, naturally. I used to put sun in my hair too, which now my hair is like pretty bad for you because it has like little tiny bits of aluminum. So, yeah, I don't know how long I'll do the brunette thing for. I'm still feeling it out, but I definitely want it cut. Okay, so here, I could show you before I put it in the little cutting pigtails, whatever it is. My hair, the ends, not like incredibly damaged. I think they're just dry, and like you're supposed to trim your hair every couple months, which I clearly haven't been doing. So I've been wanting to learn how to trim my own hair for so long so that I can keep up with it, keep it nice and trimmed and healthy. Like, look at that. That's so dry. It's dry. been like some split ends and stuff, but all in all, like, I take good care of it. I do deep conditioning. I don't know why I said that weird. Deep conditioning. I was like, deep conditioning. Deep conditioning. It was better in the summer though, because I would put my coconut oil or some kind of conditioner into my hair and then put it up in a bun and go to the beach. And the sun really helps open up the hair follicles and lets the conditioning soak in. Hair before. Like, I don't know, when I was like 12, I think. I did it like 6th grade. And I totally screwed it up. And I had to get it fixed at a salon. And 7th grade, I did it again. I was at my dad's. And I used these like big kitchen scissors. And I gave myself like baby bangs. I'm not doing anything extreme today. I'm just, you know, taking off the little crunchy bits. And I ordered these really nice scissors from Amazon. They're like official haircutting scissors. It's supposed to be super sharp to make it like a nice cut. And it came in a package with these thinning shears. These little teeth in there. So cool. So, you know, to make it a little smoother at the bottom. Alright, so I'm gonna do it like a little bit to the side. Yeah, that's probably more. This is still like, oops, lay it down to make it sit straight, and then we'll figure, and then I'll probably, I don't know, that much, maybe we could start a little lower and work our way up. Staring like a straight across kind of cut, so it's like really just not that complicated. And I do like long hair, but it just has to be healthy, you know? I'll try to grow it again, but I'll just keep up on the trims this time. You can, I got my roots touched up the last time I got a haircut, so you can like see like that how much growth I've had. And then these bangs were like here, so yeah, these are kind of awkward. I don't know what to do with them. I usually like curl them out. Okay, so now we put the little bands in. Fine hair, so it'll be kind of easy to cut as well. There's, I don't know. I've also found that my my hair isn't as wavy as it used to be, and I'm pretty sure it's because of the crunchy ends. I think my hair wants to curl, but it just like it just stops. It's like it can't go any further because down here is just like not as healthy. Alright, so where are we? It's like a little bit below the collarbone. I might go up to the collarbone. We'll see how it looks. My bunny is in his cage next to me and he's munching away. Let's just go for it. Crunchy bits off. I've been wanting to do this for a really long time. Alright. Take a break from munching. Alright, let's do this. Are they even? This side. There it is. First one down. Really clean cut, oh my god. This is a big piece. Look how precise this cut is. These scissors are good. That's so satisfying. Yeah, see, it's like, it's dry, but it's considering how long it's been since I've had a cut. Oh my goodness. This is very exciting. Yeah, I'm trying to get my hair to be curly, so it needs to be very healthy in order to do its natural curl. Alright, here we go, last one. Moment of truth. Ooh, ooh. So you know, this isn't the most extreme haircut I've done. Ooh. Ooh. Who is she? What? Isn't that much hair, but I think it makes a big difference. Yeah, this is called, I think, a lob. It's a long bob. That's kind of what I'm going for. One time, when I was around 18, I cut off 14 inches. It was like from the middle of my back, and then I cut it up like super, like really, really short. This is the most extreme cut I've done in a very long time. Oh, it feels really good. Oh, it's nice though. I dig it. Ooh. Up. Take a volume. Hell yeah. Okay. Yeah, I still haven't decided if I'm going to try to do face frame. Can you tell me how it is back there? Just kidding. Alright, so now what we're going to do... Here, I'm going to comb it through a little bit. I'm very happy. I was thinking of going even shorter, actually. But this is cool, because yeah, I was thinking about, maybe, collarbone. It's just a smidge below collarbone, but that's where it'll be. And when I curl it, I'm gonna have to level this out, you know, a little bit, but all in all, I think it'll be an easy task. And do I do face frame? What I really want is bangs. But one step at a time. Let's get this sorted out. Okay. So now I'm gonna put it up into sections to level it up. I just bought these. I've never used them. How do they open? It says safety. Start with a small section here. use my thinning shears too. I'll put the side up as well. We're gonna do little sections. You can see. Dude, these scissors are amazing. Whoa. Pretty good. And I'm okay with it being choppy too. That's kind of like the look. Alright, now blunt lob. Oh, yes, otherwise, like, I would need to, like, go in with, like, little triangles, like, at a little angle. Okay, so we did that side. Let's do this side. It's always a crazy experience when you cut off a lot of hair and then your shampoo and you over glob. You have to like realize that you don't need as much shampoo. Alright, so this one's like here. Quite different over here. So we're actually gonna take a nice bit off. This is gonna be like the biggest thing I do in a while. From here, it's just gonna be like little trims. What a cool invention. Hairdressers must have been so stoked. when my scissors came out. I actually worked at a salon for a second job. I was a receptionist, and I was also the assistant and shampoo girl. So we're gonna take down some more hair. So fun. Alright, my bunny is munching again, but I just need to keep going. Alright. Like layer by layer. So, I took a break again because my bunny was munching up a storm. Alright, and I changed the plan. I parted my hair down the middle. So, yeah. So it'll be, more straight, I guess. Science. Still a little bit shorter. It could be a little asymmetrical. That's all right. Let's see. How much do I need to take off on this side for it to match this side? Oh, it's raining. I'm gonna take this half up again and just cut just like a smidge more off the lower layer. This is a freaking boss. Okay. Perfect. Well, not perfect. Good enough. And I'm gonna be curling it mostly, so good. One little long piece. Let's see. It's about right. Once and the hairdresser went like all the way up here with it. With these thinning shears. And also it'll look different, you know, after I wash it, like style it. A little bit. Maybe like thin it. Yeah, I'll thin it first. And we'll take from there. Just like, because some of this is old as well. Need some cleaning up. scissors. You said that they were really sharp. Let's see. Right. No, that's not working. Is it working? No, it kinda, I don't know what it did. Yeah. Okay. Clean it up a little bit. I don't know what to do with these. I kind of want to turn them into bangs. Face cream on this side? I don't think so. Yeah, I'm stoked on this because look what I can do. I can like fluff it up. I can get so much volume. Hell yeah. That's what I wanted. And it feels so much more soft and healthy. I've been thinking about this for a long time. Soon.